for me to give the Midianites into their hands, lest Israel will vaunt themselves against me, saying, my own hand hath saved me. God is not going to give you that credit. So the people were too many, and the Bible says that this would they gathered the Israelites together because they wanted to make sure that nobody would boast, nobody would brag. It's not personality, it's not ability, it's not skill. As God said to Zerubbabel, it's not by might nor by power, but it's by my spirit. And in my little walk with the Lord, I know that when I get backed up against the wall, it ain't about friends, it's not about connections, it's not about association. Have you ever known that when you're jacked up and backed up and you really need help, all of a sudden you can't think of one person that you could call? Suddenly your mind goes blank, huh? Because suddenly you're, if you call that one, they're not going to be there. If you call the other one, they're going to tell you they're not available. Suddenly the Lord drops the curtain. It's not them. Don't get mad at them. Tell your neighbor, stop getting mad at people. It's because God has something greater. Lord, have mercy. He's getting ready to do it himself. Come on and put your hands together. I want to hear you praise him in this house. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He now would get rid of the timid and the fearful. Can't do nothing for God with people that are always complaining and whining and fearful and always asking the same dumb questions and always casting doubt and always worrying about how it's going to be and always going by logic and rationality. Oh, come on here. Can't win this kind of battle against principalities and powers and rulers of darkness and spiritual wickedness in high places and people around you who are disloyal and Judases in your face. You can't win that kind of battle with logic. You need a Holy Ghost strategy. Lord, I feel a help in here. Somebody help me praise him, because I'm getting ready to release the strategy. Come on on there. Hallelujah. Come on and praise him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. What kind of strategy? You've got to get rid of all these people who are dressed up like soldiers but act like cowards. They have on all kinds of garbs, but they're not able to stand the test, can't take the heat, can't go through, can't stand their ground, can't hold their head above water, can't go through the difficulty, can't take criticism, can't take persecution, easily offended. Let them people go home. Let him go, let him go, let him go. Lord, have mercy. I said, let him go, let him go, let him go. Come on and praise him in here. Ah, oh, God is getting ready to do something in our lives. Let him go. Let him go. They're a hindrance. Whosoever is fearful, let him return from Mount Gilead. Whosoever can't see the vision, let them go home until we win this battle. Whosoever can't handle the pressure, got to get off the board, got to get off the board. Can't have you tying up my decision making. Ah, because your hands are trembling too much. I need somebody with a steady hand. Ah, to hold the fort. Come on and praise him in the house. Lord, help me to praise him right here. I need some intercessors right here. Come on, Yatabo Sebeheskaban. Come on and praise him in Yatoruskabande. Hallelujah. Now, listen to this, ladies and gentlemen. These numbers are interesting. The people who went back, he had 32,000 strong. And the people who went back were 22,000. 22,000, two-thirds of this army were cowards. See how we get mixed up with numbers? We think because we see numbers, we see strength. No, we ain't seen no strength. We think when we see numbers, we see spirituality. No, you're looking at carnality at its best. No. You think when we see numbers, we see people who have made a commitment to God? No. They're just complying. They're just hanging out. They're just enjoying. They're just freeloading. It don't mean that they're up in it. Lord have mercy. You need somebody who can get up in it and stay in it. And don't go to the right or to the left. Oh, come on. It's a steady army. A steady army. Send them home. 22,000 went home. And the Bible said, and the Lord said unto Gideon. Now the Lord can be so demanding and difficult. You would think that he would give him a little play with 1,000. He turned around and said to him, you still have too many. You're still surrounded with too many. 1,000, too much. Send 700. But you can't send the 700 home like that. You got to prove them. There's a test. I'm going to show you how you're going to know who should stay and who should go. I'm setting up the test right now. Lord have mercy. Somebody help me pray. I said he's setting up the test right now, right now. I'm going to show you who is in the army with you, and I'm going to show you who ain't with you right now. I'm working it out right now. You need to know, you see, because what I'm getting ready to do for you, you need to know what kind of army you got. Come on and praise him, church. I want to hear you praise him, praise him, praise him. Oh, I feel a hollering, a hollering, a hollering, a hollering. I feel a sifting, sifting, sifting. Come on and give him glory in the house.